This video is going to cover the new way of automatically placing match line and north arrow on your plan sheets. Okay, so I've got my alignment out here. It's the Route 54 data set that we're using. I'm going to be in my drawing production tab of the open roads modeling workflow. I'm going to place my name boundaries as I normally do. I'm going to use the civil plan. Pick a drawing seat. This one you're going to see in the future, we're only going to have design, full plan, design, plan, and design, plan, profile. These other four will go away. So we're going to use a design full plan. And then I have to pick my scale. For this demonstration, I'll use 1 inch equals 50. And once I've got those two drawing seat and the detail scale figured out, then I need to pick my alignment. I just want to pick that around 54. And then it wants to know my start location. So I'm going to hit this back button to get the beginning of the alignment. And then I will just simply accept it. Now, as I do that, you can see something's happening that's different than before. Before, these were just straight blocks that came in here. Now we're using a boundary chord of 1. And this chord can change depending on the severity of your curve. 1 works out pretty well for most of it, but if it gets to be more curve in there, then you may want to bump this to 2 and possibly 3. Okay, we don't want to mess with our length and our offsets. We want to leave those alone. But we're going to come in here and just place 3 of these sheets, and I'm dynamically doing it by moving my mouse up. Okay, I also have create drawing and show dialog checked on. For plan sheets, that's fine to do. If you're doing plan profile sheets, you'll want to uncheck that, because you'll use the name boundary manager to produce those. So I'm just going to come out and place my 3 sheets out here and left click. Okay, and then I have to left click one more time to verify that's what I want to do. So it places my 3 boundaries, name boundaries out here. This is what they're going to look like. And then here's the create drawing dialog that pops up. And normally we would create 1 DGN file per name boundary. In this example, I'm just showing you how the tools work. I don't want to do that and take up too much time in the video. So normally you would select this and path out to the folder you want to store it. Also, you want to change your names for your view name, your model name, and your model name for the sheet model. You'd want to change that to something more appropriate for naming convention. In this example, I'm going to leave them as they are. So that brings us down to the next thing we need to do, which is the scale. Comes in as 1 equals 1, well, I did 1 equals 50, and it also, and this is new for the plan sheets, you're going to have an annotation group to assign, and that will give us our match line and north arrow. So if I go to plan drawing, it's the only option we have is plan annotation, load that up, and then I'll verify my detail scale matches my drawing model scale, which in this case it does. I'm good to go. So everything's set up to produce a match line from sheet to sheet, okay, and to drop a north arrow in. Okay, so I'm going to hit the OK button to let it rip. It's going to go out, it's going to create these sheets, and you can see I've got a match line on the left side. Okay. You also see we have a north arrow. Now the north arrow is just arbitrarily placed, so what you'd want to do is go into the drawing model. I'm in sheet 3, so I went to the drawing model for D3. And then I would go to my drawing tools, and this is my move option. Grab the north arrow, move it in a more appropriate place. Okay. If I go to my plan 2 sheets and look at that, my sheet view, and again, we're looking at the white papers or sheet view or the word sheet. I can open it up and I can see I've got a couple match lines. Now, using that boundary chord of 1, you can see we just have a little bit of a bleed over, so this would have to be trimmed out. You want to use a clip mask and get rid of that. And again, you'd have to come back through in the default model and then move your north arrow to an appropriate location. Okay, but you can see what it's done. Using that chord, it's given us an area where it overlaps the other sheet. So we have to be kind of careful about what we're doing in there. So our sheet, we go back here, See, you might need to clip out just a little bit down here. Now, we'll shoot one. Let's see what it did. It started at the beginning, gave us a match line. And this one looks pretty good. It looks like we're in there. And again, the only thing you'd want to do is move that north arrow to a better location, you know, wherever it might be. But you'll notice that it does bring in the match line, which is great. And it does bring in the north arrow, which is kind of a nice little bonus that it does. And it rotates it to the view that we need, or to the true north that we want. It doesn't come in straight up and down like you would if you went up to the tool and changed it and picked it from CAD standards tools. Okay, so that's what it's going to do for us with this whole match line option. Now the other part of it that I'm going to show you is that you may not want this. You may not want to use this. You may want to use your block style, and it's you could do it that way as well. So I'm going to remove these by going to my drawing production. I'm going to go to my name boundary manager, bring it up, and then I'm going to open my plan groups and delete this one that I created and edit it. So I'm going to get rid of it. Okay, and you always want to do the plan groups, profile groups, cross-section groups from this tool, always. And now all I have to do is go back to the model tool, since I created them in this DGN file. I'll have to remove them. So I'll shift, select them all, and then delete the models. Okay, now it's clean again. We're good to go. We'll check in the file that's checked out, the DGN workset file. I'll close my models. Okay, so we go back to that name boundary tool that we just used. Again, I'm going to use the design full plan, 50 scale. This time, I'm going to turn off the chords. Make that at zero. Okay, so I have to come out and I have to select my alignment. And then I have to tell it to start location. So I'm going to do that. And then I'll go ahead and left click to start the process. Now you can see dynamically we're moving these around. And we're back to the block type name boundaries, which is fine. But you can see I'm missing data over here. So we're going to have to use that overlap option. Now the overlap option, the match line doesn't really honor the overlap. So what we're going to do in here, we're going to give this like, let's see what 100 does. That in. And you can see we pretty much got it out there. I'm not concerned about the template drop, but I am concerned about my right of way lines and make sure that they're covered by the sheets, and they are. And you also notice that if I overlapped at 100, it starts 100 to the inside of that station. And I'll go out and I'll place my same three sheets. Again, I don't want to mess with my lengths, my offsets, none of that stuff. All I'm going to do is come out and left click to place my three sheets. And then I'll have to accept those three name boundaries. It brings me to my tool, my next dialog. Again, if I was doing this for real, I'd create separate DGN files for each one of these and rename the view names all the way through. I want to verify my scale, which equals 50. And I want to give it an annotation group. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Now you can do the annotation group anytime you want. You don't have to put it on here. You can come back later like we've done before. And apply an annotation group. I'm going to do it here at the beginning. Next thing I want to check is verify this detail scale matches my drawing scale. It does not, so I want to make it match. Okay, first time you do it, it'll pick it up by the name boundary to be good, but if you run them over and over, this you'll have to look for. So once this is filled out the way I have it here, we'll go ahead and hit the OK and open up the last sheet. And you'll see what happens. The offsets work. And it offset. But you see, we've got bleed over. The match line goes where it's supposed to go, and then the offset, it doesn't honor that. So what we'd have to do is we'd have to clip out that. So if I go to sheet two, you can see where it works on both sides on this. Okay, he's got both sides, it's bled over a little bit. So it's going to take a little bit of work to fix that. So if I go back to sheet three, it'll be quicker and easier, and I'll go into the drawing model to show you how this works. So what I want to do is I want to use that match line area and then cut out or clip out the parts that I don't want to see. So to do that, I'm going to go to my drawing tab. I'm going to place this shape out there. Okay, so I'll find my place shape tool. Place block. We'll do a place block. Place block will be fine. I want to be rotated. Looks like it's pretty straight, but I'm going to do rotate anyway. And I'm going to come down here and I'm going to select one end and then the other. Okay, and I'm just going to place a block out here. And then I'll have to modify the shape because I still got some area down here that needs to be kind of fixed up. So I can come down to my modify element and grab the end of it and just move it down so I get that area here with the right-of-way line clipped out at the match line as well. So this basically covers it, this shape. Now I'll go into my reference dialog, open it up, and I will select, first I need to put a fence out there, grab my fence, and I am going to do by element since I have them out there, and I'll select it, and it's by mode of insight, so it's there. Now I would come into the reference dialog, and I can do a right click, and click mask, and let's see, it doesn't work with the tools pull down, but it does work with a right click, clip mask. And once you have that option, you can go out in a blank area, and left click, and it's gonna clip it out for us. Okay, I'm just gonna drop off my selection set, close my reference. Now, when I go into my sheet model, and I look at that, you'll notice it's cut out. You also notice we see our shape. So we can either turn the level off in here, or go back and delete the shape. You're done with that shape, you don't need it. Just use it to place that fence out there. Then we'll go back into three sheet views. It's clipped out nicely. And so that's how we're gonna fight that that whole process of being able to put our match lines out there. You'll also notice there's a little battle that we're having right now with the even stationing. People want even stationing. And when you have a station equation in your project, and that is right here, it throws everything off, okay? And the more station equations, the more thrown off it gets. So getting even stations, virtually impossible at this stage. So if you don't have a station equation, yes, you can get even stationing, which is nice. But right now, where we're at right now, as we want to push this tool forward, these are the two options that we have. You can either place that name boundary using a chord on it, by using this boundary chord, and again, the more severe the curve is, the more chords you can add to it. It's still going to be rough in that corner down here in the bottom left that it where it attaches. If you don't like that, then again, take the chords off, place these shapes out there. You just will have to go back and do some editing, you know, just to get rid of those match lines to get them to look right. Okay, so you'd have to do some clip mask in the drawing model to get it to show right. And that pretty much concludes this video. If you have any questions, get a hold of me at CAD support.